assumptions are here, no? The liquid phase is completely back mixed and gas phase is plug flow. Okay, then the superficial velocity of the gas at the top is 0.05 meter per second. So as I told you, in many cases we start in an ad hoc manner. So we start an ad hoc manner, like 5 × 10⁻². So how many we have started? Vg at the top is 0.05. Pressure at the top is 1 atmosphere. Value of KLa, how much? 0.04. Value of A, 200. Then epsilon g is 0.2. Read further. Independent of column diameter and height. Now this is very important. Suppose we want to estimate hold up. Correlations are already there and how to use them I have explained to you. But this is very reliable alternate procedure for hold up mass transfer coefficient and interfacial area, which I mentioned to you yesterday. But the procedure runs like this. Suppose you take sodium sulfide NaOH solution of same concentration in the laboratory and use same superficial gas velocity and measure hold up in the column. That is, take 150 mm column, and what the text says that it has been observed abundantly in the literature that when the column diameter is more than 150 millimeters, the holdup is independent of column diameter. So, and this has been observed right up to 5 meter diameter. So, if we in the laboratory we take 150 mm and say 2 meter height and fill the liquid and pass the gas at different superficial gas velocities and measure the height of dispersion, you will get hold up. And hold up you can plot with superficial velocity. So Vg is an assumption, but whatever now epsilon g is taken, that comes from either the experiment which I mentioned to you right now. So 150 mm column epsilon g will be same as now. In our case, the answer is it is 2.89 meters, correct? No? So it is independent of gas velocity. So by using some other correlation, A has been found out or KLa has been found out. But a good practice I mentioned to you, we find with the help of Sturzel M, N, K, M, N, right, the values of which I have given you. So, by adjusting parameters in laboratory bubble column, 150 mm is not laboratory, it is called pilot plant. We push it into second regime, right. So, KLA has to be much less than epsilon LK to be naught. So, deliberately we take very high concentration. Suppose we take 0.154 in the column, which is the inlet concentration, and start the experiment. Then epsilon LK to B naught will be 99 times more than whatever we calculated yesterday, and KLA will be much less than epsilon LK to B naught, correct? And then in that case, it will be KLA will be much less than, and it is likely to be in the second regime, correct? So if we find conversion in a given time, we can find kilomoles per meter cube second. It is in second regime, we can estimate S star and find KLA. And that value of KLA, we can plot with respect to VG, and then it is independent of column diameter. Have you understood that discussion now? Which sentence is still difficult? Maybe I can read it and then you can point out. The values of epsilon L, KL and AL actually depend upon superficial gas velocity, column diameter, column height, sparger design, the nature of gas liquid system and operating pressure and temperature. At relatively low pressures, less than 0.5 millipascals, megapascals, it is known, there are references that the values of epsilon L, KL and A are independent of column diameter when D exceeds 0.15 meters. Furthermore, these are independent of column height and sparger design when H by D exceeds a certain critical value. 3 for highly coalescing system. Is this not understood? Which sentence is not understood now? Last, okay. Furthermore, these are independent of, where is last? Where does it start? Such measurements are preferably made at least at 4 levels of superficial gas velocity and 3 levels of temperature and pressure each in the vicinity of proposed operating conditions. In the present study, it is assumed that the experiments were performed as indicated above, and that at the operating conditions, UG, T and P, temperature and pressure under consideration, the values of epsilon L, KL and A are 0.82 into 10 raised to minus 4 and 200 meter square meter cube respectively. So, in the laboratory, you take the same system and by manipulating, you bring it in the second regime. So, you know gas holdup. From conversion, you can find KLA, right? And if you increase the temperature further and increase KMN, you can come in between second and third. And the rate between second and third for the case under consideration . So if you plot between second and third, it is K L square. If you plot R A A at different values of B naught, you can plot square root of B naught and then the slope is square root dAk2 A into A star and intercept is KL square A star. While it was in second regime, we already found KLA value, diffusivity rate constant, A star are all known, and we can calculate interfacial area. Is that correct? Something to be corrected? So we are plotting square root of B naught. So yeah, square root of KL. So KL, yeah, that is right. Have you understood the procedure? Is there any doubt regarding all those sentences? Now completely understood? Yeah. So this was a good question. Anything else? Any other question? So what we have assumed is temperature is 75 degrees. What else we have assumed? In an ad hoc manner, what is that we have done? Yesterday we made a list, no? 200% excess. Very good. If anything else occurs, we will try to find out. But I'm again repeating, these are ad hoc numbers. Right? Why 200%? Why not anything else? But when we start with 200% with temperature, superficial gas velocity, and operating pressure, at least we can begin solving the problem. Yeah. Equation of? Okay. then what will happen? What is intercept? What is the intercept? Now it is okay. So these four parameters we have started off, from which using correlations in the literature or using AI, we get these values. Right? After getting these values, then there is a procedure to calculate height. See, 200% excess for the oxidation, 1 mole, 1 mole is required. First of all, we can find how much oxygen is required. Then 200% excess means we take 3 times that stoichiometric quantity. And associated nitrogen will give total volumetric flow rate. And superficial velocity at the top is known, and therefore we can find out the column diameter. And when that column diameter is known, the volume of the equipment that I showed you, the solution of that problem, we worked out somewhere now. This gave the total volume and height to be 29.1 meter. Correct. So for ad hoc starting point, we have ad hoc answers. So diameter of 2.89 and height of 29.1 meters will cost something. Okay. And cost we can find out from pressure, operating pressure, but operating pressure at the top is 1 atmosphere. And I showed you at the bottom it is more than 3, even of the order of 4. So we find the thickness at the highest pressure of the column. If there is too much of a variation, then we make bubble column into different parts. Thicker one at the bottom, and then we can weld and do it accordingly. Basically, we can find the cost of the equipment, including the fabrication cost. Then, for passing the gas, we need to supply electrical energy to the compressor. We know how to calculate pressure at the bottom, and air from atmospheric pressure has to be compressed to the pressure existing at the bottom. So, from electrical energy, we can find the operating cost. So for the ad hoc selection of these numbers, we got corresponding values of A, KLA and epsilon G that gave diameter and height, and that gave annualized cost of operating the equipment. Up to this it is clear? Yeah. I have been suggesting you, even if it is the smallest doubt, these are very important steps in the reactor design. Please feel free. Yeah.
Sir, in the bubble column, the A star is defined for a differential volume. How it changes? So I did not get that definition. A star is equal to this coefficient, total pressure,
A star is partial pressure of oxygen into total pressure. Total pressure is top pressure plus hydrostatic head, right? And the hydrostatic head has been calculated, psi denotes the rate of increase of static pressure with respect to differential height. So if it was pure liquid, pure water, nothing like psi was required. We know that with different heights, how much static, it is h rho g basically. If you want to simplify this, if holdup is known to be 0.2 and liquid holdup to be 0.8, so actual static height multiplied by 0.8 multiplied by rho into g is static head. Plus one atmosphere at the top is total pressure at that location. Multiplied by mole fraction is the partial pressure at that location. Multiplied by Henry's coefficient will be A star. Understood? There will be one more opportunity today to explain this point. I'll repeat that again. It's understood now? Okay. Any other question? So a student like you, he varied superficial gas velocity. We have taken 0.5 meter per second, but he varied in the range of 0.01 to 0.2. 0.01 to 0.2. He varied pressure from 1 atmosphere to 15 atmospheres. He percentage excess was varied from 10% to 200%. So the range was 0.01 to 0.2 meter per second. PT 1 less than PT less than 15 atmosphere. Excess 200%. Temperature 40 degrees, 120 degrees. Obviously, 120 degrees must have been selected at higher pressure. And this exercise was calculated, the equipment cost, annualized cost, and the operating cost of compressor. And the final result the student got, this is 2004 student. VG is equal to 0.8. Pressure is equal to 8 atmosphere. Temperature 110 degrees centigrade. Excess 50%. Now understood? Doesn't seem to be. Doesn't matter. If you take, need to read anything 5 times, why not teach also 5 times? Correct? No? Have you understood the procedure that if we start anywhere, we can get these values? Is that clear? Any doubt there? Right. Then we derived one first order differential equation by taking balance across differential volume. The total pressure was changing and mole fraction was changing, and therefore S star was changing, correct? That was included in the analysis, and there was a solution of that first order differential equation. And for in the differential equation, these are useful values to be substituted. Superficial gas velocity gives only diameter, but that integrated equation gives the total volume. Like we found 300 meter cube for stirred tank yesterday for some combination, and 317 for some other combination. So therefore, we get volume from that integrated equation, and from the volume, we get height. So from diameter and height, we get the cost of the equipment, say 50 lakh rupees. We annualize it, and simplest way is to assume life of 10 years, so that after 10 years, we are going to discard that bubble column. So annually, it is as if it is costing 5 lakh rupees. Suppose compressor is needing 5 kilowatt and it runs for 8,000 hours. So 8,000 into 5 is 40,000, and 40,000 into electricity cost is now 10 rupees. So 4 lakh rupees per year, right? So operating cost is 4 lakh plus capital cost is 5 lakh, total annualized cost is 9 lakh rupees, right? As you go further, you will come to know little bit of manpower is to be included, little bit of maintenance is to be included in the operating cost, but that is all right. That these are the smaller micro details which you will come to know. So the total is 9 lakh rupees, which is called total annualized cost. But this is the number for the ad hoc 4 numbers with which we started. Right? These are not the answers. But for these starting points, the annualized cost is 9 lakh rupees. That much is very clear. So for some other combination, we will get some other annualized cost. So therefore, I told you that we see the sensitivity of each parameter, and therefore one of the students saw the sensitivity from 10% to 200%, temperature from 40 degrees to 120 degrees, superficial velocity by a factor of 20, and total pressure by a factor of 15 atmospheres. And he must have selected 4 or 5 values within this range, and 5 into 5 into 5 into 5, there will be some 500, 600 combinations. And in 600 combinations, he saw an optimum design at Vg is equal to 0.8 meter per second, total pressure of 8 atmospheres, temperature of 110 degrees, percentage excess is 50%. Understood? More than what was understood before this explanation. Is it 50% now? Passing marks? Have you understood up to passing marks? There are good optimization routines. I don't know whether you have studied any subject on optimization. If you start from here and you get an answer of 5 lakh for 4 lakh, 9 lakh rupees, that becomes an objective function which depends upon superficial gas velocity, total pressure, temperature and percentage excess. Have you studied optimization? So these 9 lakh rupees, first of all, the annualized cost, how does it change with respect to percentage excess? I'm telling you one of the optimization. There are very, very good optimization routines. So D annual cost to D excess, that differential is calculated. D annualized cost to D pressure, D annualized cost D temperature, and D annualized cost with D total pressure or D VG at the top. So we march in the direction of the highest sensitivity, which is contributing maximum, which is maximum sensitivity. Having calculated next value, we again calculate these numbers and march in a faster way towards an optimum value. Whatever optimization routine I told you, I did not expect that you should understand, but I'll be happy if you have understood. Understood? The first part or second part? Second part understood. First part is not yet understood. From the starting point, how to get AKLA and hold up, is that understood? Yes or no? Yes? No? Okay. Yesterday I wrote some correlations on the board. Those were empirical correlations. For all the three parameters. Did I write on the board? So we pick up such correlations. There is one book on bubble columns, but there are good number of review papers as well as in handbooks, such correlations are given. So we pick up correlations from handbooks and I have picked up three of them and found AKLA and epsilon J value. Indeed, part four is very difficult, is difficult. But having explained how to get it, that is pick up a correlation, or you have been told how to use artificial intelligence, you put your values of column diameter, column height, height of submergence, etc., physical properties of liquid gas, and you will get AKLA values. So this particular step has not been developed in a fundamental manner. This has been developed in an empirical manner. Do several experiments. In the correlation, there are parameters like sigma, that is surface tension, and density, and perhaps power consumption, or superficial gas velocity, and many more terms. So in the laboratory, interfacial area is measured using third regime. Over a wide range of these parameters, we get objective function interfacial area, and then by developing some dimensionless numbers or dimensional numbers, we try to correlate by regression in the laboratory empirical correlations for AKLA, KGA, etc. And different investigators report such values. There are, for such commonly employed equipment, some experienced people, they recommend certain correlations. And those experts are typically are the authors in the handbook. So we pick up these correlations from the handbook, and if these are not available in the handbook, there are books. And if there are no books in a particular subject, for stir tank, bubble column, pack column, plate column, you will get correlations in the handbook. These are commonly employed equipment. But if it is jet loop reactor, then you will have to go to, fortunately there is a book on jet loop reactor and sparge loop reactor. But then there are good reviews which periodically appear every 10 years or 15 years. Those who have worked for 10, 15 years in that particular area, say for example, Venturi as a gas liquid reactor. Then somebody works for 10, 15 years and writes a nice review paper. So we go to the review paper. So using keywords like Venturi scrubber, we can get that review paper. And then try to get those correlations. And using the correlations, then we get these values. Now understood? Still not? Understood?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, okay. But these are the values for the some starting point, for some starting point. And having obtained these values, how to get column diameter and column height, that I explained to you yesterday. I think there is a difficulty there. Because the main difficulty arises because of one repelling term called error function in the equation. And that equation is also fairly long. I'll do the following, okay? I'll change the methodology of teaching as well as the methodology which I taught you yesterday. I will change that methodology also, okay? And let me teach you an alternative methodology and let us see what happens. See, even if we don't understand now, you have at least heard me. Can I assume that? You have heard me? Yeah, completely. Yeah, right. So, and you have your notebook also with you. So, whenever there will be real problem, some disruption will occur. Wherever knowingly or unknowingly it is absorbed, some disruption will occur. There will be percentage excess and is not absorbed. Right? But that's okay. When you start, you will face questions. You will have your notebook with you and you will continue. So with large number of obstacles and difficulties and thinking, and perhaps some moments or hours of frustration, eventually you will solve the problem. And like I said yesterday, you may get some unreasonable answers. I mentioned some unreasonable answers yesterday. Column volume of 1 million meter cube or column height of 5 kilometers is not unreasonable. I had to talk on the other side. In one of the examinations, I had given a problem, and answer was 0.001 millimeter column height. So we make mistakes. Particularly, we make mistakes in units. We are sometimes familiar with atmosphere, but which is equal to T typically 1 × 10⁵ Pascals. And when that 10⁵ is forgotten, then 10-meter height can be 100 kilometers. Right? So this is the first check that whether we have used proper units. Then, of course, all the numerical calculations we check again and again, and then eventually we get first answer, which may take several hours or perhaps even several months. Having done that, later you will never make a mistake of units, at least. That itself is excellent progress, right? It's excellent progress. Then you will learn from orders of magnitude in which direction we should proceed. Is pressure sensitive? Is percentage excess sensitive? And in that manner, when you design, say, 10 equipment, then you are fairly all right under those conditions, and eventually you will get it. But still, I'm not going to leave you. I'm going to teach you the same example in an alternative manner, okay? But before that, okay, what I was considering is to teach you pack column where the diameter was something like 2 meters and height was 0.5 kilometer. How did we get that answer? And yesterday the answer was given. The reaction happens in the liquid phase, and liquid itself is only 10% in the column. That is, liquid flows in the form of a film from the top to bottom and occupies 10%. So whatever is the reactor volume is only liquid volume. And in bubble column, liquid is 80%. Therefore, we get 8 times the volume in a packed column. If diameter is 2 meters, then height is 0.5 kilometer. So that particular procedure I was going to teach you. But now I'm telling you my modified decision. And if you agree, then only I'm going to modify. Bubble column you have not understood. Is that fair assumption? That is, how height was calculated, 29.1 meter, is not understood. Array, say something, yes or no? Yes means not understood. Yeah. Okay. So I'm extrapolating that and saying that if I teach pack column today, then that also you are not going to understand. Fair assumption? So anyway, if I was going to teach you alternative procedure and hoping that you will understand that, then why not teach you alternative procedure even for pack column, even for plate column, even for stud tanks? So let me try an alternative procedure. By the way, you will realize at the end, you realize yourself. So let me start with alternative procedure. But I would confirm before I proceed further, for the design, we start somewhere because we need, in any procedure, in any form, the values of KLA hold up, values of KL, in order to calculate root M and the regime in which it operates. It may be in first, between first and second, second, and we have seen in one case that it is between first, second, and third. So these values are required anyway, and some of the values like KLA are required in the integrated equation. So from a starting point, where from to get these values I will now take for granted that only this much part you have understood. Is that fair assumption? Yes? No, not yes. I can read some of the faces, but I don't want to point out. Only last four benches where students are sitting, only they will answer. Have you understood?
Yes, sir.
Are you only one? Front three benches. Have you understood?
Yes, sir.
I would like to see, let us not worry about speed of teaching. It is not covering a portion. I don't think whatever I'm teaching, it can be captured by sentences in the syllabus. There is some syllabus, obviously. But I want to teach you which is needed and not for examination. Definitely not. No, that is not very true, because anyway, examination has to be held. So a small objective is examination. Big objective is that you understand the subject of multiphase reactor design. Ask me just one question related to only that marked portion. Arbitrarily start from somewhere and using correlations in the published literature or using artificial intelligence, which will be made available publicly now, we get the values of design parameters like hold up, interfacial area, and mass transfer coefficient. Is it understood? Yeah, okay. So this is now, with this, let us go further. Okay. Now, yesterday I explained the procedure, how to get diameter, how to get height, how to get the volume, but it is not understood completely. But the student who understood, he calculated annualized value. Right? And how to calculate annualized value, have you understood that? Yes? Yeah, right. So for 29.1 meter height and 2.89 meter diameter, he calculated thicknesses, metal weight, and fabrication cost, and he annualized it. And compressor energy he calculated. And then he varied the percentage excess from 10 to 200%. And calculated annualized value for all these cases, five levels or even more under each category, and he calculated annualized cost, and his answer was the total cost is minimum at this combination, pressure of 8 atmospheres, superficial gas velocity 0.8. We had started with 0.5, but optimum answer is 0.8. We had started with 1 atmosphere. Optimum answer is 8 atmospheres. We started with 75 degrees. The answer is 110 degrees. Percentage excess, instead of 200%, it is 50%. So the procedure, one who understands, he can see the sensitivity of all the parameters on the total cost and finally can make a recommendation. Have you understood only this much? Yeah, right. Now, I'm going to tell you an alternative procedure, a design procedure. Be frank enough, otherwise I'm going to teach you a third procedure. But I will do it in such a way that after teaching second procedure, there will not be more confusion at least. Right? There will be better clarity. That I will try to take care. See, you have been responding. I have been teaching you now for must be at least somewhere in between 25 and 30 hours put together. One point I have understood is that you are intelligent. All of you individually, you are intelligent. And you are capable of understanding. Either subject is difficult or I have not explained sufficiently, therefore there is something which needs to be repaired. So now there is a repair procedure, but before I repair, let me not say that sentence. Yesterday I also promised you that non-ideal flow, the Pecquelle number or dispersion number, was not derived in the class. And the extreme ideal conditions of completely back mixed and plug flow, when does it happen? That quantitatively was not taught in the class. This is what I understood from your presentation. Is that correct?
Yes, sir.
And you have not understood the procedure for bubble column design. That is also true. That I confirmed just now. So I am going to put these two things together. And without adding much to the confusion, the two subjects, I am going to teach you an alternative method. None of the phases move in an ideal manner. Either back mixed or plug flow, correct? There are deviations from plug flow and there are deviations from the back mixed. What we try to do is try to see the actual situation, whether it is closer to the plug flow and we can understand deviation from plug flow. Our actual situation is closer to the back mixed and try to understand deviation from back mixed. Correct? So that is done with the help of Pecquelle number, and that I am explaining you. Imagine a reactor, and this is bubble column, pack column, anything, loop reactor, sparge loop reactor, jet loop reactor, plunging jet reactor, or the rotating disk vessel that I taught you, and pack column with any packing. So imagine, don't worry that I have drawn horizontal, actual column is vertical. But these two lines are representative of all the columns. Okay? Now take this statement as granted. Okay? Or you can close your eyes and try to dream how bubble column can be fitted in those two lines. I can draw vertically also. Let me draw vertically. So bubble column, a pack column, a pipeline reactor, so let me start, this is zero, and I take distance x from the top and this is dx. Sometime during the course of first two or three lectures, I said that the transport rates, let it be heat transfer, mass transfer or momentum transfer, which happen in a molecular manner, these are very slow. And therefore, we deliberately introduce turbulence in the system by supplying energy in different ways. There are impellers, there are bubbles or particles, and there is a friction across the interface. Energy is required for sustaining them, which is supplied through compressor or motor or any moving machinery. What is that we try to do, how to put the energy, in what manner and at what locations, so that the overall exercise is economical. All right. So here, I am taking differential element at distance x. So whenever we incorporate turbulence, the transport is now occurring in addition to molecular motion by turbulent dispersion. Did I say this earlier? Yes? Right. I gave you example of milk in a glass and mixing. So by moving a spoon inside, we introduce turbulence, and in addition to molecular motion, we incorporate eddy motion. And eddy sizes and velocities are orders of magnitude higher than the molecular motion. And therefore, the eddy viscosity as compared to the molecular viscosity, which we know as viscosity, eddy conduction or eddy conductivity or eddy diffusivity is orders of magnitude higher than the molecular viscosity, molecular conductivity or molecular mass transfer. So the under turbulent conditions, the material moves, obviously it moves because of convection, and it moves with the combined effect of dispersion and diffusion, right? I don't know, suppose there is a curtain between two of us, there is a curtain between two of us, and on my side is completely chlorine, and on your side it is completely oxygen. Can you imagine that? Imagine. There is a molecular motion on chlorine side as well as on the oxygen side. Now lift the curtain. Molecular motion is everywhere, and because of molecular motion, the Fick's law defines the flux. The concentration gradient multiplied by diffusion coefficient is flux. At the beginning, the huge concentration gradient, total chlorine on this side, total oxygen on your side, and when the curtain is lifted, at the interface of curtain, there is an infinite gradient, right? And there will be oxygens will start rushing to my side, chlorine will start rushing to your side. And eventually, some uniformity of concentration will happen in terms of oxygen as well as chlorine. Now to this, there will be certain rate, and this rate is not acceptable to us. Therefore, we introduce turbulence, and there are about 12 fans existing, or 15 fans. How many? in the last 1, 2, 3, 4, 17 fans, yeah, right. So all the fans are acting as if they are individually spoons for mixing sugar, and they will create turbulence inside. And there will be eddy diffusion. As a result, what will happen, if by molecular diffusion, if mixing takes several days, when fans start rotating, it will happen in maybe few minutes, right? But this we always remember, we can never stop diffusion. Molecular motion cannot be arrested. By incorporating turbulent diffusion, we have made it negligible, but we have not made it zero. So this is one way of transport. Now imagine through this wall, there are several holes which are uniformly distributed and oxygen is passed from there with certain superficial velocity. You know the cross section, certain superficial velocity it is passed. Now in addition to the molecular transport and turbulent transport, there is a convective transport also, correct? No? Physically, now oxygen is coming from your side, that is by diffusion and turbulent dispersion, but through this wall, oxygen is coming back convection. There is a superficial velocity, and superficial velocity multiplied by cross section is the volumetric flow rate by which I am receiving oxygen from this side, I am receiving oxygen from this side, and as a result, I will start getting good oxygen in a much shorter way as compared to if convection was not there, as compared to turbulent dispersion was not there. And we try to maximize the rates using the combination of anything in addition to molecular motion. Only dispersion, a combination of dispersion and convection, and in some cases only convection, if it is possible. Particularly in those cases we use convection where generation of turbulence is difficult, polymerization reactors. There are various applications like paint making. They are very viscous and introducing turbulence is very difficult. So we try to develop only molecular motion is anyway there. Plus we try to take help of convection and try to do the job. We try to enhance the rates with the. So therefore, reactants are coming. And let me say this as B naught O. And from this, it is B naught exit. Then this is Y at the beginning, and this is Y at exit. I think we have been writing Y exit, Y. But we have not defined the equipment in between, right? We have not specified percentage excess, we have not specified operating pressure. Since equipment is not there, right, we don't know how much is pressure drop, we cannot calculate the pressure on the other side. But 200 tons per day and the liquid flow rate QL, please tell me how much was that? Point some zero something meter cube per second? 2.32 meter cube per second. These kilomoles per second, is it known? B reacted is equal to 0.00232 into 0.154. Minus 0.0064. Correct? Tell me the answer. How much? 2.2 into? 200 tons per day. This is what? How many kgs per meter cube? Starting 12 kg per meter cube. An outlet was, I think, 0.5 kg per meter cube. So I just divided by the molecular weight to give the concentration. So what is the stoichiometric oxygen needed? Which is equal to 3.42 into 10 to the raised to minus 4 because the equation given is twice of oxygen plus twice of Na2S gives the products. Z is 1 in this case. Percentage excess is equal to 200. Therefore, molar flow rate of oxygen is equal to 10.26. Into 10 to the raised to minus 4 kilomole per second. This is molar flow rate of oxygen and therefore molar flow rate of air is how much? 4.88 into 10 raised to minus 3 kilomole per second. All this is understood? Right? Let me start with very simple case. I am going to teach you an alternative procedure which I believe you will understand. And therefore, I have drawn two lines or perhaps four lines inside which any equipment that you desire is sitting inside. But the job is given. The job is written now on the right hand side. The net liquid flow rate is given, inlet concentration is given, outlet concentration is given, molar flow rate of gas is given. But still, I would like to, for teaching purpose, so that it becomes easy to understand. Let me consider initially only liquid flows and gas is not yet sparged. Okay? Gas is not yet sparged. So I have taken differential volume and whatever, now only liquid is flowing. So whatever B naught is flowing inside, the flux is occurring both by convection and combination of diffusion and dispersion. Any transport is a combination of diffusion, dispersion and convection. I mentioned to you, I am receiving oxygen by convection, diffusion and dispersion. So let me denote diffusion and dispersion by D. So if I write mass balance now, mass balance and the concentration is B naught. So minus diffusion plus dispersion coefficient put together, which D? Anyway, let me try to write this D. So combination of diffusion plus dispersion of component B so we are writing mass balance for differential volume. So this is a flux multiplied by cross sectional area S, which is happening at X, minus diffusion coefficient. While I wrote this this particular term, there is one error there. Can you point out that error? I wrote flux as minus diffusion into concentration gradient. What is the error? So the Fick's law says that the flux happens in the direction of decreasing concentration. The flux happens, occurs in the direction of decreasing concentration, and in the direction of decreasing concentration, gradient is negative. And therefore we write diffusion or dispersion coefficient into concentration gradient minus, because flux is anyway positive. So what is happening here, as the dimension X is increasing, is B decreasing or increasing? B is decreasing. and flux is happening, is it happening in the direction of decreasing concentration? Yes, right. So there is no error. There is no error. So minus, actually plus, no? Minus dB by dx. At x plus dx now something will happen by convection, that is if VL is superficial velocity plus VL into B naught into cross sectional area, basically superficial velocity into cross sectional area is volumetric flow rate into concentration is the molar flow rate at x minus VL into B naught into S at x plus dx. So while it is moving from this place to this place, in the differential volume, reaction is occurring. So minus RAA into SDH is equal to 0. So basically we write in minus out minus reacted is equal to 0. For in, it is due to dispersion plus convection. Out also by dispersion and convection. Minus reacted is equal to 0. So take the limit divide throughout by SDH and take limit as S tending to 0. Have you able to see everything written on the board? Yesterday somebody had put light. What is written in the corner is not visible here. Only one curtain. Thank you. Right, solve the problem. So mass balance says there is something coming in, going out. Whatever is the net is reacted, put together is zero, correct? Of course, under steady state. We will definitely operate the industrial reactor at steady state to get the production of 200 tons per day. So therefore, we wrote minus dB though it is single phase, I am still expressing the nomenclature, I am not changing. Volumetric rate of reaction, I am, or let me take another notation with which you are more familiar, minus Ra into SDH, SDX is equal to zero. So this rate is kilomol per meter cube second. This is a differential volume in terms of meter cube of that differential volume. Is understood now? Seen also clearly? Now divide throughout by S dx and take the limit as dx tending to 0, with which you are familiar. The answer is dB times D2B D2B by dx square. Minus VL into dB by dx. Minus Ra is equal to 0. Let me make some of the variables dimensionless. Let me make one. Suppose this total length of the reactor is L and define capital X as small x upon L. Small x upon L. So the same equation, I think this is our material balance in minus out minus reacted is equal to accumulation. that particular equation u number 1 and this u number as 2. So if you substitute this, then you will get dB times dB naught d2B naught d2B naught. We have been, did we write B or B naught in the B naught? Right. D2B naught by dx square and dB by L square minus VL upon L. dB naught by dx minus RA is equal to, what is that, L square should be in the numerator? It should be in the numerator. Think again. It's okay? Yeah. Let us divide throughout, divide throughout by L into VL upon L, divide throughout by VL upon L. By the way, L is length of the reactor. L is length of the reactor. And VL is superficial velocity. So what is the significance of L upon VL? Yes? The units are time, that is correct. It's very good. 50% marks. L upon VL is mean residence time, correct? It is mean residence time. That is the time over for which the reactants stay inside. So divide throughout by L upon VL and note that L upon VL is equal to residence time tau. So we get dB upon L into VL into D2B by dx square minus dB naught by dx minus RA into tau is equal to 0. Call this as equation 3. So we got two dimensionless numbers, one dimensionless number positively, that is dispersion coefficient, dispersion plus diffusion coefficient upon L into VL. So this derivation was not done in the class, I'm unable to believe. Was it done? I'm saying, Harry, somebody has to bring Levin's pill. Who agreed? Somebody agreed, no? So you have Levin's pill? Not now. So come here. Book has been really extensively used.
Not by me.
But I'm happy, very happy. I say read 5 times, gives a feel that it has been read 200 times. The basics of non-ideal flow, chapter 11, was it covered in the class? Covered in the class. So it starts with definition of back mix flow, plug flow, and then this derivation is there. What is the meaning of residence time distribution, mean residence time, the variance, the Peclet number? Up to that you know. But where is the source of Peclet number that was told to me yesterday? That source was not taught. Is it still correct?
Yes.
Yes? Yes. Okay. Let me believe. Anyway, I was opened. So open the chapter number 10 and it is there. So it is equation number 6 on page 296. And that is not chapter 10. In this book it is chapter 13. So perhaps chapter 13 is not taught in the class. When I was learning in 70, it was 8th chapter. It has been split into 4 chapters now. Anyway. Now, examine the numerator and denominator. dB is dispersion and VL is convection. So in a reactor, if dispersion is much, much greater than convection, the flux is occurring in a major way by dispersion as compared to convection, this means the rate of mixing within the equipment is much greater than the net rate of flow across the reactor. And we call this as a back mix reactor. Sometime in initial lectures, I told you the comparison between mixing time and residence time. So if mixing time is much less than the residence time, say 20 times less, 50 times less, then it in 2% of residence time, the contents are completely mixed and mixing happens because of dispersion. So therefore we can assume that if in 2% all the contents are mixed, so concentration at all the locations within the reactor is same and call it as back mix reactor. So So if numerator is much, much greater than denominator, and there is a customary to write the same equation in an alternative form, 1 upon PE, where PE is Pecquelet number, D2 B naught by dx square minus dB naught by dx. Minus array into tau is equal to 0. And this PE is Pecquelet number and is equal to L into VL upon D. So if D is much greater than L into VL, or as PE tends to 0, we call it as back mix reactor. As PL tends to infinity, we call it as a plug flow reactor. All right? But instead of infinity, we need some visible number. So for our purpose, let us take 20. If it is greater than 20, it is close to infinity. And therefore, likewise, if it is less than 0.05, then, so whether it is completely mixed or not completely mixed, or it is completely plug flow, Pecquelet number is greater than 20, let us call it as a plug flow reactor. And when it is less than 0.05, then it is called as back mix reactor. It is understood? I started with an objective of teaching you an alternative procedure. That procedure needs the definition of Pecquelet number. Therefore, I use the same opportunity to explain to you whatever you wanted the explanation, that is derivation of Pecquelet number and the physical significance of Pecquelet number. If mixing occurs predominantly by dispersion and diffusion as compared to convection, and mixing time is much less than residence time as a result, then it is called completely back mix reactor. When mixing time is much greater than residence time, or dispersion is weak as compared to convection, then it is called plug flow reactor. Weak means by order of 20 for our purpose. Mathematically, Pecquelet number infinity is plug flow reactor. Mathematically, Pecquelet number 0 is back mix reactor. So these limits we have understood. Limits is on one side, but physically we have understood that if mixing takes priority over convection, then it is anyway back mixed. And if dispersion, the mixing phenomena is weak in axial direction. In axial direction, no mixing is happening. When we say no, or Pecquelet number infinity, then it is a plug flow reactor. But we have taken now limits as 0.05 and 20. And therefore, the alternative procedure says that for no reactor, it is less than 0.05 or greater than 20. It is in between. And therefore, let us have a generalized procedure. Right? The gas flow in bubble column is non-ideal. Liquid flow in bubble column is non-ideal. The gas flow in stirred tanks is not back mixed, it is non-ideal. In packed column, we started with a procedure of liquid phase and gas phase both moving in plug flow manner, which is not true. Liquid phase is non-ideal, gas phase is non-ideal. Okay? though we have taken higher version for understanding, I am very confident the way in which you are reacting, you will understand this alternative procedure. I have an appointment now. What do we do? Whatever I wanted to teach, I taught nothing from whatever I wanted. But whatever was needed, that I taught. And what I want is not important. That is not important. What is needed is important. What do we do? We are definitely meeting on Thursday and Friday. Friday, do you still have that mechanical engineering class? Saturday, I'm not around. So let us solve this problem. Am I available on Monday? How are you placed on Monday? So I answered, no, my question. We always start at 3:30, correct, no? Monday is 25th, no? So let us meet at 3:30, okay? We requested once. We should not take advantage. We should not take undue advantage. So 4:30 is okay with me. So let us meet 4:30 to 7. But please come out whatever is not understood. I'm making it sure that whatever I want to teach, anyway I'm going to teach eventually. If not today, eventually I'll teach. So let us now, other than Monday, what is available to you? Tuesday I'm not available. Let us see two times only next week. And then if we get two more times in the next week, following week, that should be sufficient. That should be sufficient. So we'll plan in that manner. Let us see the rate of progress, the way in which we are proceeding, but I am happy with the progress, and then we can decide then. So with this alternative procedure, we need not integrate the equation, and that integrated form for bubble column, for pipeline reactor, for sectionalized bubble column, for packed column, it has frightened you, that integrated equation, such a long algebraic equation. The result is not understood. So I'm not going to involve now any algebraic equation. No complex nonlinear algebraic equation, absolutely nothing. How many of you know how to solve ordinary differential equations numerically? Raise your hands. You know Rangekatta? Starting from simple Euler's method? No. Rangekatta is known. How many of you, Python, somebody said to you. How many of you know Python? Okay, it's not required. Not required. MATLAB, is it formally taught in the class?
Yes.
Yeah, okay. So I'll teach you procedure which is very, which the equation, all those equations will be, will get, will remain accommodated on the blackboard and not what is there in the printout, okay? But that printout is correct, is correct. You should read it 5 times. I have given you the final answer. The students and then the, I told you some other students solved all those 44 problems or 46 problems. And I have announced already. So the hard work, simpler procedure, or in other words, that not, I don't consider any procedure as difficult, but learning that procedure and understanding that, you will cover miles and miles. It's a good idea.